What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about creating an Active Directory security assessment report. So let's get right into it. All right, so today is all about creating a security assessment report for your Active Directory. This is like super important, especially if you want to make sure everything is kosher within your Active Directory. So we are going to be using this, Purple Knight. This was introduced to me, I would say maybe 2 or 3 years ago when a job site that I was working at, they needed to do like an audit. They hired like a pen tester. They actually had us download this and run a report, which is pretty awesome. There is a paid version, but the free version actually works with no problem. So once you hear, at the very bottom right there, where it says file underneath the nice little icon with the arrow and a bracket, that is a hyperlink. So click on that and that will download the zip file for you. Now, I already downloaded it within the downloads folder and it is right here. Bingo. We're going to right click on that zip folder. We are going to select extract all and we're going to select or click on extract. It's going to start extracting everything and eventually you're going to get this, which is great. We are going to, let's select the PK Community 5.0 folder. Let's double click on it to open it up. And this is everything that's inside of it. Now, before we start running the exe file to start the installation and start, you know, creating our report, we need to do a couple of things. So we are going to right click on the start menu. We're going to select Windows PowerShell as an admin. We're going to click on yes on the user account control. And the command that we need to run would be the following. Okay, we need to unblock the files because apparently this utility uses PowerShell. So depending on where you dropped it, you know, the path would be the location of the folder. It has to be the root. So it has to be PK Community 5.0 that you're going to be unblocking everything. So this is the command that I ran. I'm going to hit enter. Nothing really happens, which is okay. But if you do not run this, the installation is going to fail and you're going to have a lot of problems. Let's head back into the downloads folder. Now, the exe file, we are going to select it. We're going to right click on it and we're going to click on run as an administrator. You're going to get the user account control. We are going to click yes here. And it's going to start. And eventually you're going to get this. Excellent. We're going to check off I accept the terms in the license agreement. We're going to click on next. Bingo. You're almost done running the report, which is cool. On the upper right hand side, you're going to see like three little dots. Click on the three little dots. And best practice is make sure you check for updates to push down whatever it needs. Even though you downloaded the latest and greatest, but it's best practice to check for updates, okay? I didn't do it within this machine because this machine is offline, but again, most likely your machine has access. Don't run this on a domain controller. Run this on a machine that's part of the domain. Now, we have three options. You are able to pick whatever options you want, but for this video, we are only going to focus on Active Directory, so let's give it a check mark. We're going to click on select. By default, it should pick up your domain, which is great. It did for me. I'm going to click on select. Excellent. I selected my domain. We are going to click on next. And this is everything that's going to be tested within your Active Directory. One of the things by default, which is checked off, if we expand AD infrastructure security and we scroll down, the zero login is by default unchecked. Best practice is to run it without it and then go back and then check it off because this takes forever. This process takes for a long time. I think last time by mistake, I checked it off the first time and it took maybe 2, 3, 4 hours. It just took a long time. So best practice, leave it unchecked. It is unchecked. Once you run the first initial report, come back, check it off and let it, you know, do its thing. We're going to click on run tests. It's going to start running its tests. Eventually, you're going to see the progress bar underneath done. For my test is 118, so 45 of 118 was completed. And, you know, go grab something to eat, come back, and eventually you're going to get this. I got 77, a C minus. That's not, it's a testing environment, but if you're red, make sure you fix those problems. What you could do from here, where it says save as, click on it, and we're going to select full PDF report. We're going to drop our PDF into a location because this is a report that you're able to provide to your manager or open it up, make modifications, edit that PDF so you can start working on all those problems. We're going to click on save. Give it some time. Eventually, you're going to get this. Excellent. Say successfully. Would you like to open the output folder? I click no here, but I like to click on view report and it's going to open up your default browser, which is this. From here, review everything. Scroll down, you're going to see some of the issues that came up. And if you scroll even down, you're going to get a lot of the critical IOEs that were found. I got a lot of them. But this right here is, you know, a nice report for me to review what needs to be done within my Active Directory. This machine is offline, so it doesn't have any internet access at all, which is okay for my testing environment. But for you, if you have an Active Directory and you run this report and you have a lot of critical and it's production, look into it, how you could patch up your Active Directory. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.